हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला. दिस इज सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द इकोलॉजिकल सक्सेशन मॉड्यूल. इन द प्रीवियस मॉड्यूल वी हैव लर्नड व्हाट इज इकोलॉजिकल सक्सेशन एंड व्हाट आर डिफरेंट प्रोसेसेस व्हिच आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर इकोलॉजिकल सक्सेशन एंड वी हैव आल्सो लर्नड अबाउट द डिफरेंट थ्योरीज और डिफरेंट मॉडल्स दैट हैव बीन प्रपोज्ड बाय डिफरेंट साइंटिस्ट फॉर द इकोलॉजिकल सक्सेशन. The learning objectives of this module are to learn about concept of climax community, to know about different theories related to climax community, to understand the process of ecological succession by examples of hydroseed and gyroseed, to learn about different serial stages of hydroseed, and to understand different processes taking place in gyroseed. So let we start with the concept of climax community. The climax community is final, terminal and self-perpetuating community in succession, as it is a more or less equilibrium with itself and its environment. It represents a steady state of species composition, community structure and energy flow. At this stage, there is equilibrium between gross primary production and total respiration, between amount of energy and nutrients received by the plants from the environment and return back to the environment in more or less same amount by decomposition process. The individuals of the climax stage are replaced by others of the same kind. Thus, the species composition maintains equilibrium. The climax community has the several specific characters. Let me discuss them one by one. Climax community is able to tolerate its own reactions. Climax community has a wide diversity of species, a well-defined spatial structure and complex food chains and food webs. The species of climax community are more or less stable with the climate. This climax community cannot be replaced through competition by any other group of species. The developmental stages of climax community have their own characteristics which reflect the type of climate. There are three theoretical approaches to the climax. Let we discuss them one by one. First one is monoclimax theory or climatic climax theory. According to monoclimax theory given by Clements in 1960, there is only one type of climax community in a climatic region. It is the climate that controls the occurrence of the life forms of the dominant species and which in turn become the characteristic appearance of that climax community. All other communities existing besides the climatic complex are called as subordinate communities, and these communities are a subclimax is a stage in succession just preceding the climatic climax community. The disclimax or anthropogenic subclimax is the community in an area replacing true climax community as a result of recurrent biotic disturbances. The preclimax is a community of lower life forms than the true climax and results from different edaphic conditions in the same area. The post-climax is the community of higher life forms occurring within a climatic climax due to slightly better moisture or colder conditions in that zone. Second is the polyclimax theory. This polyclimax theory was proposed by Tensley in 1935. According to this theory, the structure and stability of climax communities in a region forming a mosaic of vegetation climaxes are controlled by a number of factors besides the climates, and these factors include soil moisture, soil nutrients, topography, slope, temperature, fire, etc., and also includes various biotic factors. The influence of physical factors is so strong that the two different climax communities on the above site cannot converge to single climax community even in indefinite periods. This figure shows the edaphic climaxes, redwood forest and pygmy forest. Tensley has recognized five types of climaxes. First one is climatic climax. Climax under the normal conditions of climate, soil and topography and no disturbance is called as climatic climax. Then topographic climax. The climax community stabilized by topographical factors of an area such as hills, mountains, slopes, etc. is known as topographical climax. Then edaphic climax, when stable and self-perpetuating communities develop in parts of the same area due to peculiarities in soil, that is variation in edaphic factor, and are different from climatic climax, then they are known as edaphic climax. Then fire climax, when climax community occur in response to recurrent burning of vegetation which eliminate the fire susceptible species, then such climax community is known as fire climax. Then another category is biotic climax. The climax of biotic community stabilized by living factors including man, herbivores and other animals are known as anthropogenic climax, grazing climax and jutting climax respectively. Climatic, topographic and edaphic climaxes are considered as primary complexes, whereas fire and biotic climaxes are called as secondary climaxes. Climax pattern theory. Whitaker in 1951 rejected classification approach of describing climax and proposed climax pattern theory. According to this theory, the communities that occupy the largest area in this equicline are known as the prevailing climax or climatic climax. This theory recognizes a spatial pattern of climax vegetation which reflects the spatial variation in the environmental conditions at that point. There is thus no discrete number of climax communities, and not a single factor determines the structure and stability of a climax community. So, in a nutshell, we can say that the end point of ecological succession, that is climax community, is not completely stable. The climate of an area has a significant control on the occurrence of species, but within each broad climatic zones there are other several factors like soil, nutrients, topography, biotic factors, etc., which lead to many climax situations. Climax communities do not necessarily represent a halt to successional change. Now, let we take example of succession. First, we take the example of succession in hydroseed. Hydroseed is the ecological succession which occurs in a water body like pond, pool or lake. In a newly formed pond, the process starts with the colonization of phytoplanktons. The pioneer community, and through a number of intermediate serial stages, finally reaches a forest as climax community. The whole process of hydrosear from an open water body to a forest may take at least 200 years or even more than that. The different stages of hydrosear are plankton stage, rooted submerged state, floating stage, reed swamp stage, sedge meadow stage, woodland stage, and finally forest stage. This figure represents the different stages of hydrosears as we have studied just now. So on the left hand side, first stage is shown, that is phytoplanktons, and on the right hand side, the final stage is the forest stage, that is the tree and other land plants. Let me discuss these stages one by one in detail. Plankton stage. The pioneer colonizers of the hydrosear include phytoplanktons like blue-green algae, green algae, and diatoms. When these organisms die, after their death, decompose and result in the release of minerals, which in turn will mix up with the silt brought from the surrounding land by rainwater and by wave action of pond water. Rooted submerged state is the second stage. The soft nutrient rich mud at the bottom of pond now becomes suitable habitat for the growth of rooted hydrophytes like Myriophyllum, Elodia, Hydrilla, Potomogeton, Vallisneria, Utricularia, etc. These submerged plants have roots at bottom and remaining portion in water. The next stage is floating stage. Some free floating species such as Azolla, Lamna, Wolfia, Piscia, Spirodella, Salvinia, etc. also become associated with rooted plants. These species increase in their number due to high availability of nutrients, and their dead parts fill up the pond ecosystem gradually, resulting in the further built up of the substratum. Next stage is red swamp stage. Pond margins, because of good environmental conditions of high moisture, enough light and aeration, soon gets covered by emergent hydrophytes. Although their root system is completely under water and anchored in soil, but their shoots are partially or completely exposed to air. So are like amphibian plants. Then sedge meadow stage. Further decrease in water level changes the nature of substrate. They form a mat like vegetation towards the center of the pond and give the pond a marsh or swamp like appearance. The next stage is woodland stage. Due to exposure to sun, terrestrial plants and trees form open vegetation or woodland. By this time, the area is rich in humus with rich flora of microorganisms. Thus, the competition favors the arrival of new tree species. Next stage or penultimate stage is the forest stage. Many trees whose seedlings are shade loving invade the area. They cover the whole area when they grow and develop. This is the climax community. Depending upon the climate, the climax will be rain forest, temperate forest, or tropical forest. Lithosphere. A gyrosear on rock lithosphere is a type of gyrosear succession which originates on rock surface deficient in water and organic matter. The rock surface is in unweathered state. The pioneers to colonize this primitive type of substratum are lichens. And finally, gyrosear ends with a climax community. The various stages of gyrosear succession are crustose lichen stage, folios lichen stage, moss stage, hub stage, shrub stage, and forest stage. This figure shows different species of lithosphere or gyrosphere succession. Here you will see on the left hand side, this start from some rock and ultimately on the right hand side ends into a forest, that is the climax. Crustose lichen stage. Under such conditions, blue-green algae and lichens can grow and multiply. In cooler climates, crustose lichens are the common pioneers. They produce some carbonic acids which bring about withering of rocks in the form of cracks or roughen the rock surface. Second stage is foliose lichen stage. It appears on the substratum, particularly built up by the crustose lichens. The foliose lichens can absorb and retain more water. They not only add organic matter but accumulate dust particles and help in creation of humus. The withering of rocks mixed with humus form a thin soil layer on rock surface, and thus there is a change in the habitat. Next stage is moss stage. Now the built up stratum favors the growth of certain xerophytic mosses. At their successful growth, they compete with the lichens and overshow the foliage lichens. The moss also acts like a sponge when wet, in some cases providing a semi-aquatic microhabitat for a variety of invertebrates such as mites and spiders. Next stage is hub stage. The extensive growth of mosses add more soil and moisture to the surface. Minerals are added to it due to leaching. The soil is now fit for generation of seeds of xerophytic hubs. These will shade out and displace the moss, which enabled them to survive in the first place. Next stage is shrub stage. Now the habitat with enriched soil becomes suitable for the growth of shrubs. The shrubs overshadow the hubs and replace them. At this stage, a number of herbivorous invertebrates that feed on particular plant species also start inhabiting the area. Next stage is forest stage. Due to increasing humus content in soil and release of minerals from weathering of rocks, thin layer of soil is formed, which supports small trees. The first species of the trees are relatively xeric with stunted growth and are widely spaced. Gradually, the xeric species may be replaced by mesophytic and may give rise to new herbaceous vegetation in that area. So, to summarize this module, in this module we have learned that the climax community is final, terminal and self-perpetuating community in succession. And it is more or less in equilibrium with itself and its environment. According to monoclimax theory, each climax is direct expression of its climate. The climate is the cause and climax is the effect, which in turn reacts upon the climate. Clements proposed four terms for these communities, and these terms were subclimax, disclimax, preclimax and postclimax. The polyclimax theory was proposed by Tensley, and the climax community in a region form a mosaic of vegetation climaxes and are controlled by a number of factors besides the climax, such as soil moisture, soil nutrients, topography, slope, temperature, fire, etc., and various other biotic factors. On the other hand, Whittaker rejected classification approach of describing climax and proposed climax pattern theory. As a result, the climax community represents a pattern of population that corresponds to the changes of environmental gradients forming ecoclimate. Hydrosphere is the ecological succession which occurs in a water body like pond, pool or lake. Lithosphere is a type of gyroseed succession which originate in rock surface deficient in water and organic moisture. I hope you have enjoyed this module. Thank you.